Welcome to your inspirational astrology horoscope for Wednesday, January 9th, 2013. I am astrologer David Palmer, here to illuminate the collective consciousness. Well, a couple interesting things going on. I'd say the most interesting is now Venus is in Capricorn. And now we have four planets in Capricorn. We got Venus, we got Pluto, we got Mercury, we got the Sun. A lot of very personal planets to us. And especially this very big outer planet, which is changing the structure of our lives. We are building a new foundation. This is also the skeletal system. Capricorn rules the bones, the knees as well. And this is us making our bones stronger. It's kind of like calcium, you know, like making sure you're drinking your milk right now. It's kind of the energy. But sometimes, you know, milk cannot be the funnest thing to drink, but it's more important because what it's doing to our system. Whatever's happening in your life right now, it is building a new foundation in your life, one to make you stronger, one to make you reach your highest goals. Now, very interesting because Venus, you know, which is our feminine planet, it does rule the females, by the way, and most importantly, it does rule how we feel good. It also rules relationships. Venus has just traveled through Sagittarius, opening us up to new relationships, opening us up to new ways and new beliefs of how we will feel better in our life. Now that it's in Capricorn, it's really going to go through a restructuring overhaul. You know, one thing about where Sag meets Capricorn is we come into this big belief, and then when it reaches Capricorn, it's like, okay, like, let's actually reach the top of the mountain and do something with it and make some plans with it. So with relationships now, it's going to take a serious turn. With how you feel better, it's going to take a serious turn to make sure you have a nice solid foundation, to make sure that you're reaching your best goals. And you know, with relationships as well, you know, planning and making some serious moves is actually okay. It can be kind of dull, you know, Capricorn energy can be kind of dull, but the moon in Sagittarius today kind of stirs this thing up as, ooh, we're, you know, emotionally really feeling in this jovialness, we're really more excited. So ever since yesterday, this energy is really, you know, picking us up here and making sure that we're seeing a big picture, that we're emotionally, you know, not going too far, especially because, you know, what's really going on is life is serious. Life is making sure that we're gonna make it the best ever. So whatever you're doing right now, make sure that you're making some serious plans, that you're grounded, that you're most importantly making sure that whatever it is that you're doing, that you're cutting down to the deepest part of your soul, that's because Saturn's in Scorpio, you're getting to understand the frustrations, the delays that are happening, and why you can't achieve, most importantly, the true desires you want. It all comes with a new change of mind. Remember, we've talked a lot about this mind stuff. I know it's probably getting old now, but the truth is, coming in here on January 30th, finally when Jupiter goes direct, there's gonna be a lot of new energy coming in. This is really the abundance train. God has a bunch of levers that he keeps, you know, on and off with the planets, and we've got all the planets but Jupiter on. So the only lever off is our abundance of really, you know, the lottery kind of like woohoo energy, which, you know, the moon's here so we can kind of tap into that. But most importantly, our minds are still a big part of everything. So as we're stepping into the new structure, as we're really making some heavy decisions on, you know, what is coming in between what it is that we want to desire, what is coming in between the intimacy things, you know, there's a lot of intimacy things. What are the fears that are bubbling up? We can emotionally learn from these, especially since for the last, you know, 3 days, it was kind of intense. We had some fears we had to face. We had to understand, you know, what's going on. Why can't I reach these goals? Because there are some connections that we can't connect to. And these are connections even of whatever emotional state we can't connect with. If you want to feel happy, well, why are you afraid? These are weird energies that we have to slice into. And this is the power now to really push forward and innovate. The last couple days taught you to face your fears, and to most importantly, as you understand what they are, to move in new directions, to try new things. By you progressing forward and doing new things, especially a new structure of your life, because we're all in Capricorn here, emotionally tapping into your beliefs, not worrying about the details like the mind wants to right now, but actually seeing the big picture for yourself helps you make your life become more solid, more strong, have some strong knees. You know, we all don't want knee surgery like all those Laker players. That's why they suck so bad. But, you know, we are moving into a great time because the moon getting ready to come into Capricorn tomorrow, and we're going to have a new moon coming up here in Capricorn with five planets here to make us really come into the structure of our lives to reach our highest potential. Check out my website, david-palmer.com, for your 2013 forecast, and I also have my astrology classes. I have an instant astrologer package and one-on-one readings. Plus, if you want a love reading, hit me up, David at david-palmer.com. I'll see you guys tomorrow.